Little Rosa was her name, and though she died in vain, my tears won't be the same now she's gone from here. Friends, I've just been to the cemetery today to visit the grave of an old friend of mine. And while I was there, I saw an old man kneel inside the grave of a child. And in his hand, he held a big red rose, and the tears were streaming down his cheeks. So I walked over to this old man and asked him what his trouble was. And this is his story, as he told it to me in his broken English. He said to me, "Boss, today I'm a-walking down the street, and I walks into a big flower shop. I walks up to the man at the counter, and I asked him how much for one big red rose, please. The man, he turned round to me, and he said, $1, please." Well, after a while, a young lady walked in the shop, and she asked the man the same question, the price of a rose. The man, he turned round to the young lady, and he said, "$0.05, please." Well, after the young lady had left the shop, I walked back up to the counter, and I asked the man why he charged me $1, and yet he only wanted 5 cents off the young lady. The man, he said to me, "You tell me why you want the rose, friend, and maybe I'll give it to you for nothing." So I says to him, "Boss, I'm only a hard-working Italian. I works on the railroad. I only get $3 a day. Back home, I got a little girl called Rosa. She's only so high, boss. And every night when I come home from work, my little Rosa runs down the railroad track to meet me. And when she meets me, she throws her arms around me. And she says, 'Papa.' And I say, 'Rosa.' And that's the way it is, boss, between me and my little girl. Well, one night, I'm coming home from work, and I don't see my little child anywhere. I looks up the railroad track, and I sees a big crowd. I walks towards this crowd, and I pushes my way through it. And there, lying on the railroad track, was my little girl, all crushed and broken by a big railroad train. So you see why I want the rose, boss. I want to lay it on the grave of my little child." Well, the man, he don't say nothing now. He just walks to the back of the shop, and he picks the biggest and the reddest rose he can find, and he gives it to me. And I thanks him. I says, "Thank you, boss." Although she's gone, you see,